Anna Mugeche. It is very early in the morning. I'm preparing something and I've thought I should share this with you. I've had two segments about questions that our children ask about sex. That is questions and answers about sex. If you haven't watched those two segments about how we should answer those questions, please subscribe and watch. This is Anna Mugeche and the channel is Bringing Hope in Life. By the way, I'm still taking interviews about stories of hope. If you have a story that you want to share, I am here. I will listen. In this platform, we listen. We help where we can help. And reach us. The contacts are there down on the video and you'll be able to reach us. So today, again, I want us to talk about our children. If you don't have one, you could be having a niece, a nephew, your sister's kids, your cousins and all that, and your neighbors. And having answered about the questions that children ask, you know, children are very inquisitive and they ask a lot. I would want to help those first-time mothers and even those who have not known, when should you teach your children how to bathe alone? How to take a shower, not really a shower, how to bathe alone, it can be a shower, or how to clean their bodies, their small bodies, alone. Because you know what? When we're talking about the questions and answers about sex, we said these children become curious when they're very young and they are able to touch themselves very much. And at age 3 going up, that is a time when they are very vulnerable and they can easily be raped. They can easily be sexually molested. And you never know where the pedophiles are. And the pedophile could also be in your house in form of the caretaker. So this is the time during birth, it is the time when these kids can be sexually molested. It is a time when they can be raped even, and especially because they are kids, it is sexually molested. And so we need to know, when can we teach our children how to shower or how to bathe alone? And this is the video for today. I want us to discuss on when we should teach them. I said I'll use my experience. I'm not a doctor. I do counseling. But out of the experience, I feel I should share with you this because it has worked. And I'm also going to discuss on how you teach them and where they should start. Now, I went for a seminar some times back when my firstborn was in pre-unit. And I remember the facilitator saying that this dad has never eaten kids. Dad on the body. So whenever they start on the shower and there's water that has that falls on them, that means they are good to go. I was reading another article where they are saying that a child should be cleaned thrice in a week. I don't think I've done that, probably when they are very young, but when they start walking, they bathe every day. The two-year-old is bathed or cleaned every day. That is how I believe. That depends on how you believe. But when are we supposed to teach these kids how to do it? Remember, we've already taught them about the private parts. They know their private parts. They know how they are supposed to cover them. They know those are the parts that they are supposed to clean very well. And out of experience, I'll tell you what I did. At 4 years is when I taught my firstborn how to clean himself. It was very hard because of that small body. There are some who start them when they're 3 and a half. Remember, these kids have just started expressing themselves. But teaching my son, my firstborn son, and the sister, I started teaching them very well at 4 years. So take them to the bathroom. I show them how to apply soap on the bathing towel. And then how to apply it. Okay, they don't have the strength of doing the very much scrubbing on their small bodies. I showed them how to do it. This way they could not do it, but I remember buying a very long bathing towel and it's like this, they couldn't reach here. But as you teach them the most important parts that they're supposed to clean, because if they don't do it well, especially girls, they will start smelling and then the infections will start from there. Have you ever wondered why you've had infections for your small girls? Say that the toilet is not very clean, the toilet which is being shared, or they cannot clean themselves properly. So you show them how to clean their armpits, their ears, and their bum bum. And that's it. Once they know how to clean that, and of course their face, they are good to go. And then after teaching them how to do it, that is from 4 going up, because these kids are very vulnerable. You may have those girls who are sent from hell and they molest your kids. They show them sexual activities that they can satisfy themselves. We've heard from the news how there was a priest, I don't know whether it was a priest or a man, from the church compound who was calling boys and girls to beat him on that part, and once it is very big, he tells them, I don't know to do what, and those kids are already introduced into sex and all of that. So it is important to know that a pedophile or somebody who is interested in admiring those small bodies and even molesting them could be in your house. You never know that. So it is always good when the kids reach at that age, you show them how to bathe alone. And then, because they, of course, at first, they won't clean themselves very well. Over the weekend or when you have time, you pass through their body, try to clean them, because of course, you would imagine this part. Remember, those people who are of my age, third floor, close to fourth floor. You remember when we started showering and you could see this. You guys, did you see that? Have you ever seen kids who have... I am very brown, but you see black spots. My son is laughing because that is what I saw. I saw that with my son, I saw that with my daughter. But I didn't mind. Whenever I had time, I would try to scrub them and all that. Oh my God. And right now, they are doing it very well. And a pedophile could be out there. We look for security. But inside the house, it is safe. It can also happen, but at least when you teach them about this sex thing and then you teach them how to bathe, they are aware that those are their private parts and nobody should touch them, nobody should see them. And I'll tell you this before I close. When I taught my daughter at 4 years, she was not able to wash downwards. That is on the private parts and the bum bum. And you know now, because she's a kaboom, you know, she's a bit... she has nyama. You guys, you'll forgive me because I used to laugh. And so, because she's a bit healthy, let me put it like that. So she could not make it. And whenever you go to wash, you could see for sure she has not washed properly. So I taught her how to go about it, and it was well. It was very, very much well. So they know how to shower, they know how to scrub themselves, and it was well. So how do you clean your babies? What are you doing? How do you clean them? And then you are able to clean your kids. So how is it? Excuse me. That is it. So you scrub, you show them how to shower, you show them how to bathe, and then they rinse themselves. Once they have applied soap, they know the armpits and all those parts, the ears and all that, because you don't want them to have this black part. After they apply soap and all the bubbles are all over, then you open the shower, especially apart from those who have the bathtubs, it will not be very safe for them because they can drown. But if it's a shower, you just open the shower and rinse off the bubbles of the soap and she's good to go. And then if it's girls, remember we said they cover themselves up to here. If it is boys, up to here. And we are good to go. And we are able to cover our private parts. And trust me, if you do that, you will not have stress with your kids. After doing that to my daughter for 4 years, for the first few months of the year, of the fourth year, she refused to be from showering. So that is how they mature. And they know their private parts are not supposed to be seen even by their mothers. I hope this has helped you. It has inspired you. It has empowered you. And this is all what this channel of hope is about. Empowering, enlightening, educating, inspiring, and ensuring that at least we are reading from the same page. And if we are not, we help. May God bless you. Don't forget to subscribe. Touch that button and subscribe. And thank you so, so much for continuing to show me love. And if you have any question on this comments column or section, please ask, comment. If you want any services of counseling, I'm there. Book, contact me, and I will tell you how. So may God bless you, and may you subscribe in Jesus' name. Thank you.